Elastic waist pants. Import the avatar and the basic pants pattern from the library. After selecting rectangle and clicking in the 2D window, you can input dimensions in the pop-up window. You can make a group of symmetrical patterns by pressing Ctrl-D. Show arrangement points and arrange the waistband. Use the segment sewing tool to sew the waistband. You can change its position by altering its arrangement in the property editor. We need to make sure the shape of the waistband will fit the body's curvature. The center front of the waistband will be lower than the center back. Add curve points at the corner to maintain a right angle. Press Ctrl and moving a point can move it along the curve. It should be able to maintain a smooth curve after simulation. Freeze the waistband, and then use the free sewing tool to sew to the pants. After creating the first sewing line, you can press Shift to sew multiple patterns. Activate the waistband and simulate. Select the Edit Sewing tool, then select the sewing line at the center, back, and merge it. Using Bond on the waistband allows it to maintain its shape and makes the pattern is less likely to slide. In the library, we can select shoes and then replace the shoes on the avatar. Shorten the length of the pants. Freeze the waistband in the 3D window. Because the waistband is frozen, after decreasing the shrinkage warp, the pants will be pulled up, so that we can make the leg opening. Selecting rectangle and clicking in the 2D window, you can once again enter dimensions in the pop-up window. You can make a group of symmetrical patterns by pressing Ctrl-D. Use the segment sewing tool to sew the leg opening. We can modify the position of the leg opening while simulating. Applying bond on the leg opening allows it to maintain its shape and makes the pattern is less likely to slide. Lowering the particle distance can help the pattern fit the avatar more accurately. Freeze the leg opening, and then use the free sewing tool to sew to the pants. After creating the first sewing line, you can press Shift to sew multiple patterns. Adjusting the shrinkage warp to 100% will create many wrinkles at the leg opening. When moving the pattern outline, click right to input a specific distance in the pop-up window. You can control the wrinkles by modifying the length of the pants. Remove the linked editing on the waistband. Apply elastic to the pattern outline and change the ratio to 100. This will keep the original length of segment and shouldn't cause other lines to stretch. Select the waistband pattern outline and then offset as internal line along the curve. Apply 100% elastic to the internal line as well. To fix the position of the waistband, you can press W and click the garment to add a pin. Select the waistband and layer clone over. Uncheck elastic and bond on the cloned waistband. And remove link to editing. You can double-click the center point of the marquee box to use the center point as the axis and modify the scale of the waistband. We can delete the sewing line created by the layer clone and re-sew it with the free sewing tool. Change the sewing line type to turned if it is overlapping. It will keep the sewn area flat. Sew the two sides of the waistband. Select the waistband and right-click Superimpose Over. It will arrange the pattern on the outside based on the sewing line. Ensuring the pants are stable, we can freeze the pants pattern, then simulate. For some small patterns, we can lower the particle distance to produce finer details. Apply 100% elastic to the leg opening to maintain the length of the pattern outline. Select the leg opening and right-click Layer Clone Over. Remove link to editing and uncheck elastic and bond on the cloned leg opening. When matching patterns do not have symmetrical information, we can apply symmetric pattern with sewing. We can delete the sewing line created by using Layer Clone and re-sew it with the Segment Sewing Tool. Select the marquee box and lengthen the cloned pattern. When the outer layer is larger than inner layer due to the size difference, we will create many wrinkles. We can increase the shrinkage weft to get the same results, and also lower the particle distance to produce finer details. Next, we are going to create the pocket. Select Line 3D Pattern in the 3D window. You can draw lines on the pants and add curve points by pressing the Control key. Select Edit Line, 3D Pattern, and select the line on the pants. In the right-click menu, you can cut the pants and pocket. Select the pattern outline of the pocket, offset pattern outline, and change the side segment type to extend. Use the free sewing tool to sew the extended part of pocket to the pants. Don't forget to change the sewing line type to make it flattened. Apply a layer value of -1 to the pocket. The simulation will now automatically identify which pattern belongs on the inside and which pattern belongs on the outside. When the pocket is in right position, we need to reset the layer value to 0 to avoid collision issues with other garments. Use the Edit Curve Point tool to modify the curve of the pants. Select the pants and use Layer Clone Over in right-click menu. remove the instance-linked editing, and then apply symmetric pattern with sewing. Increase the shrinkage weft and shrinkage warp to make the outer pattern bigger than inner pattern. After reducing the particle distance, the wrinkles and other details will be smoother. In Library, Material, Fabric, we can browse the fabric presets in Marvelous Designer. We can use knit cotton jersey for the elastic waist pants. Increase the shrinkage weft and shrinkage warp to create more wrinkle. Add the dropped shoulder long sleeve hoodie. You can learn how to make this in another tutorial video. Arrange the pattern in the 2D window. Select the hoodie and set its layer value to 1. We need to freeze the pants. This will allow for a more stable simulation. After the hoodie is outside of the pants, activate the pants and reset layer value to 0. And then, simulate.